on April 8th of 2000, Mark Hoogenkamp was in a bar. He left the bar about closing time, and the group of five individuals had been in the bar harassing him. Then they went outside, followed him, and beat him senseless, stomped on him, and did some pretty bad damage to his brain. The doctors had to rebuild his face. The impact on the brain from the assault was such that he was in a coma for 9 days.
To see your 38-year-old son having to learn how to eat again, taking his first steps, I mean, seeing your 38-year-old son starting to walk again, and seeing it, it's heartbreaking. He was there for 40 days in the hospital. And then they dismissed him because he couldn't pay for it when he was on Medicaid.
I took care of Mark for 2 years after he got out of the hospital. I mean, he really literally had to learn everything over. And he went to therapy for a very short time. It was all these physical therapies he went through and talking and word search and all this stuff. And he was just starting to get, you know, some of the stuff back, and then they just like cut it off. That's it, that's all you get. You know, you come home from work and he's building this little miniature building, and looks like hell. It's just made from old plywood, nasty stuff, and pieces of stuff you find around the yard. And it's developed into a world, his own world.
This is me. After the attack, of course, always smoking. But I used to carry one revolver, and then General Patton gave me his other revolver. So now I have two. Because the general just wants to hang out and have a drink. What's this all about, man? When the teenagers kicked my head to pieces, they wiped, I mean, everything, all memory of everything. My memories that I do get, they come back in stills, just a single shot, but no context. All I have is a photo to remind me that, oh, okay, I was married, wow. To a good-looking girl, too. But she was a Russian-Polish. Anastasia. I started to ask questions because I didn't know who I was. I had to ask other people. What was I like? Was I a bad guy? Was I mean? And they would tell me, no, you weren't mean. You were just drunk. You're an all right guy. Did I hurt anyone? No, you just hurt yourself. And then I started finding my drunk journals and started reading those because I wanted to find out who I was. For real. Because the only one that would know is the guy who was right, and that was me. You know, not maybe not in the right frame of mind, but it was me.
It's all messed up like this because I was hammered. I'm gonna die tonight. And, oh, January 19th, 1993, last entry.
You know, I was like, my God, it was like reading this something that Stephen King wrote or something. It was bad.
I never want to see this guy again.
I figured, all right, well, what's the first thing I gotta work on? That's my imagination.
I came flying over in my P-40 Warhawk on fire. And I saw a 5 field down below and I crash landed it. And when I walked into town, there was nobody there. And one by one, beautiful Barbie looking women started emerging. I was the only man in town and 27 Barbies. The SS, I found out later, went through there and killed men. It was like a desolate town. And they all hid when the SS were there. So they came out and they thanked me, and I was thinking, boy, what a lucky guy I am. So they gave me my own place, my own building, which I turned into a bar. I used to work there 5 days a week, you know, 10 hours a day. But now I just work once a week, and it's 4 or 5 hours a week, just so I can get that used to doing things again.